The Truth Beneath, aka There Is No Secret, is a story of a politician and his wife navigate a scandal after their daughter goes missing on the eve of the national elections. Starring Sun Ye-jin and late Kim Joo-hyuk under the direction of Lee Kyung-mi, this movie is one of the great projects of SYJ thus far. Though it didn't do well in the box office, but she won 6th Best Actress for this movie. 25th Bill Film Awards, 36th Korean Association of Film Critics Awards, 3rd Korean Film Producers Association Awards, 17th Women in Film Korea Festival, 17th Busan Film Critics Awards, and 22nd Chunsa Film Awards. This was an interview of Sun Ye-jin by Danga.com, back in June 2016. The interview was also featured in HanCinema.net, entitled, Sun Ye-jin, I Was at War with Fear. Sun Ye-jin said she was always at war with fear. She's been in various types of movies, but she always felt fear. However, the source of her being able to concentrate on acting and only acting without a scandal in her 15-year career may be from fear. The Truth Beneath actress spoke honestly and boldly, without any affectations. It was impressive to see how she spoke with her thoughts in her words, and she introduced her new movie as another turning point. The lights in the studio reveal my skin clearly and of course, I don't like it. I want to look pretty and young. But this movie made me forget that. I put everything aside and became free. The image she wants to show the public and the image she expects of herself put her through conflict, but she's refined her values. My image isn't something I can make. It's been 10 years since my first image through movies and ads was created. That's my image. I chose The Truth Beneath with courage, and I needed it not just because I was a mother with a teenage daughter. I am an active wife in helping my husband, Kim Joo-hyuk, run for the member of the National Assembly. At the same time, I struggle on my own to find my missing daughter. I just hope the public doesn't see me as a specific person. I have always attempted change, but I can't help being aware of other people. I have survived that until now. It's hard to find an actress who has been in various roles, like Sun Ye-jin. She claims she's run. It would be a lie to say I've been happy all my acting life. I have had struggles and sometimes things didn't work out the way I planned to. She gained the power to overcome her struggles through people. I have many old friends. My agency has been with me since high school, my makeup and hair designers have been with me for 14 years now. They are important to me. Sun Ye-jin mentioned she saw the documentary about the late Amy Winehouse. Art comes from experience, so what about me? I wonder if a healthy mind would bring out a better performance. An actress has to control herself and its stuff. I don't avoid stress intentionally. Whenever she feels stress, she goes on vacation. She loves to travel. I walk around in sportswear. There's no limit to traveling. Sun Ye-jin had also an interview in VLive for promoting her movie The Truth Beneath. Q, your character in the movie is not a typical mother character? SYJ, maternal instinct of a mom who lost her daughter, was shown in different way. In this character, in order to deliver more convincing and to be more sympathizing to the audience, I have really put in a lot of thought into this. Love for the daughter, the obsession that I must find her, things like these, I tried to balance all of these a lot. Q, 15th year since the debut. What does this movie mean to Sun Ye-jin? SYJ, the pureness and freshness of when I first started action is gone at my current age. In my 15 years of acting, the things I kept getting better at are, of course, technique and the depth of my acting abilities. But I think this movie was a chance to grow in terms of acting. It was a chance to refresh myself. Q, do you remember your first acting experience? SYJ, the first scene, I debuted on a TV drama show on 2001. It was my birthday, January 11th, was my first shoot. I didn't know anything, but they told me to act. I remember being scolded a lot. It was really painful. I wanted to be good, but I couldn't act as I wanted to. For many years since my debut, my worries were focused on how to act better. Q, what part of acting attracts you? SYJ, I really like to observe. And I have a lot of interest in psychology, in expressing the inner side of a person. You can really do it while living a normal life, while doing a normal job. So, there's that kind of feeling I can act and express this. That kind of joy is there. The interviewer told SYJ that she had the eyes of the directors. I didn't think I would do this forever, but I never thought about when I would end my acting career. I went to school at Daegu. I came to Seoul after graduating high school and became an actor. I am still an actor? That kind of thought occurs from time to time. I don't feel amazed to find actors who think of me as a role model. I can't say that it's something that has to be that way. Q. What do you say to people who come to you for advice? SYJ. I think there's no right answer. Even I don't know, doing this is right. That kind of answer is not known to me yet. You could give it all you have, but you don't know if you will succeed or not. However, you have to give it more than 100% in order to be good at something. You have to keep torturing yourself. Keep honing your skills and expand your experiences. If you keep doing it, someday, I think you will become the actor you wanted to become. Q, you have lots of secrets? SYJ, an actress is harder to be than a female pirate. If you look into anyone's life, in deep, everyone has a lot of joys and sorrows, ups and downs. And all the ordeal that he/she went through is something we can truly grasp 100%. There are just too many stories in one person's life. Including myself, I've been acting for some years, and there are so many happy points of life. But there also was that many painful moments in my life. I think that's it. Q, what would compensate for that pain? SYJ, if it's painful, don't do it. If I don't want to, I can't just stop being an actor. But even if I wanted to rest, in few months, I am reading a new scenario. So, there must be something that keeps making me want to act without me knowing. Q, you are famous for your eye smile? SYJ, I didn't know I smiled that way. Many people really like that figure in me. It's hard for me to open my eyes while I smile. So, I really feel grateful for that. Q, female actors are always exposed to the public's eye about their looks. SYJ, regardless of where they live, many people are curious about an actress' looks. Even natural creases are used to say she's old. So I want to keep showing a beautiful appearance as a female actress. You can turn back the time. Natural wrinkles, natural sagging, these can be a way to become a better actor with a depth. Of course, I think it is also a duty as an actor to show the best condition you can be in. But being obsessed with just outward appearances is not a good thing. Q, acting seems to be the priority. It can be many other things, but acting seems to be. SYJ, I think I can't help it. You can't part between a Sun Yi-jin as a person and Sun Yi-jin as an actor. Acting has become my life. Q, it must be hard if you can't separate between work and life. SYJ, today's shooting is done, let's go get a drink. Things like this, we finished shooting, let's go play as a club. You can't really do that. If you get your picture taken, it might be bad for the movie. So life as an actress is living without a lot of different variety of experiences in a small space, but you have to show a lot of acting spectrum. It is actually really ironic. Q, have you ever thought of Sun Yi-jin in your 40s? Have you ever thought about it? SYJ, actually, I have not thought about what kind of acting I would do in my 40s. There must be differences in the scenarios that come to me, and I just have to show my best from that point in life. I think that's it. Recently, I am watching a TV show, Dear My Friends. I look at the actors that act on the show and gets a lot of pushes, with all the acting experiences. And life experiences are in their acting, I want to act like them later on. This was the second project that Sun Yi-jin and Kim Joo-hyuk worked together as a married couple. The first one was My Wife Got Married. Sun Yi-jin said, every time I met Kim Joo-hyuk, we were not an ordinary couple. But I am happy that we're working again in this film and a long time has passed. So our acting has gotten better. Right. They both said that if ever they will work again as a couple for the third time, they hope to be an ordinary couple and amicable household. In this movie, Kim Joo-hyuk was slapped 3 times by Sun Yi-jin. KJH said, I was never been slapped like that in my life. My neck still hurts. I still have muscular aches. And I'm surprised and shrink back whenever people raise their hands. Yes, I have a trauma now. Sun Yi-jin said, that scene was a really important one. It was a tough scene out of the emotional ones. It was a scene where the take was like a one scene, one shot. So we had to click well, do lines in between, and had to slap accurately. Actually, I was slapped first. So, following that, I slapped him 3 times. KJH, her eyes changed after she was slapped once. SYJ, no, you have to slap well, so there are no mistakes. My palm hurt for a long time after I slapped him. My hand hurt so much that my fingers, my palm hurt more than he did. What was so funny was that I was slapped at once, then I slapped him 3 times, and all the staff members asked me if I was okay. So, he said, I was slapped 3 times. KJH, I just slapped her with the tip of my hands. SYJ, I slapped him with this part of my hand. I should have hit him with my fingers, but I didn't him well, and have never slapped anyone before, so I slapped him in an ignorant manner. So, I felt really bad. Sun Ye-jin was asked about her chemistry with the director. She said, at first, I was worried and excited. Women could click well, but there are times when we could feel uncomfortable with one another. So I was concerned, but actress Kang Hyo-jin positively recommended the director to me. I asked her beforehand. Sun Ye-jin's friend Um Jae-won talked about her in an interview, and director Lee Kyung-mi of The Truth Beneath was asked why she cast SYJ-Q. Didn't actress Sun Ye-jin feel the burden? Director Lee, we didn't know each other at all when I gave her the scenario, but I thought she'd do it. Because if I was an actress, I'd want to do it. Um Jae-won, the thing that amazed me is that Ye-jin was a lot younger than she is now, but she was a mom of a middle school student. When actresses play the role of a mother and the work is received well, you'd likely to keep playing similar role. There are such kind of concerns, of course. We asked, will you be okay? Will you be okay? But she didn't think much and said, Yuni, this is a project I can try challenge my acting on, and I thought that she's cool. Q, what do you think about Sun Ye-jin's acting transformation as a friend and colleague? Jae-won, it was extremely very very good, because it was something I've never seen from her before. Sun Ye-jin herself said, after filming The Truth Beneath, I realized how to think and twist ideas. When you look at the scenario, you'd interpret it in general. Ye-jin said, I feel like I was able to open my eyes to something more. Q, what was the reason for casting Sun Ye-jin? Director Lee, when Miss Hong Dang-mu came out in 2008, Hyo-jin and Ye-jin were at war for Best Actress Award. I went to a premiere, and turns out that those two are friends. I also saw them at a drinking party, and I thought it was like seeing them in an official setting, so it felt different. When I wrote the script for The Truth Beneath, with the images that we have of Ye-jin, elegance, cute, pretty and feminine, I was curious about how the pleasure of breaking the image, I thought the audience would find it fun if her image transformation charms were shown.